भूगोल पोथी पतारे पछे भूगोल पोथी पतारे पछे न पाऊ तार नाती छोट मोर गाटी छोट मोर गाटी
नमस्कार किट विश्वविद्यालय स्टेडियम परिसर दूरदर्शन सीधा प्रसारण को आपण मान स्वागत करना आज 69वां भारतीय विज्ञान कांग्रेस द्वितीय दिवस जहां गत काली उद्घाटन करते भारत माननीय प्रधानमंत्री डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह आज उद्घाटित होगा शिशु विज्ञान कांग्रेस हजार हजार संख्यार शिशु वैज्ञानिक मान शिक्षक अभिभावक भावगण उपस्थित उत्सव मुखर हो उठी किट परिसर तेज सब बड़ आकर्षण हो शिशु विज्ञान कांग्रेस को उद्घाटन करेंगे भारत पूर्वतन राष्ट्रपति एवं विशिष्ट वैज्ञानिक डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम केवल से नुहे जातीय आंतर्जातीय ख्याति संपन्न अनेक वैज्ञानिक आम गण में उपस्थित आप देखिपुंट आरंभ हो उद्घाटन उत्सव आम गण में अच्छा मुख्य अतिथि डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम एवं अन्य मान्यगण्य व्यक्तित्व माने अच्छा सांसद डॉक्टर प्रसन्न पाठशाणी महोदय निश्चित भाव में ओडिशा एवं ओडिशा शिशु वैज्ञानिक मानों पर आज एक विशेष अवसर
Often we give our children answers to remember rather than problems to solve. A very warm good morning to one and all present here. Respected chief guest of today's function, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Honorable Ex-President of India. Respected Professor Geeta Bali. Respected Professor Geeta Bali, General President, 99th Indian Science Congress. Respected Dr. Prasann Kumar Patsani, Honorable Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha. Respected Dr. B.P. Singh, Head NCSTC, Dr. V.L. Saxena, General Secretary, Scientific Affairs, Respected Professor Dr. A.S. Kolaskar, Vice Chancellor, KIT University, Esteemed Dignitaries of the Dais, Dr. A. Samanta, Founder, KIT and KISS University, Professor Yashpal, Eminent Scientist and Educationist, Delegates of 99th Indian Science Congress, Media Persons, and my dear friends, I, Harris, welcome you all to the inaugural function of 19th Children's Science Congress.
साथी मैं सत्येंद्र आप सभी दर्शकों का एक बार फिर से हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता हूं। दोस्तों परिभाषा हमें हमारी जिंदगी को एक रास्ता देती है एक लीक देती है जो परिभाषा पे चला वो सफल हो गया जो नहीं चला वो फेल हो गया लेकिन हर एक परिभाषा के कुछ अपवाद भी होते हैं लेकिन उन अपवाद के बारे में आप क्या कहेंगे जो उदाहरण बन गया सिर्फ भारतवर्ष के लिए ही नहीं पूरे विश्व के लिए ही नहीं पूरे ब्रह्मांड के लिए और मुझे नहीं मालूम कि आपके आने वाली पीढ़ी आपको इसके लिए याद करेगी कि नहीं कि आपने अभी तक जिंदगी में क्या पाया या क्या खोया नहीं लेकिन मुझे आज पूरा यकीन है कि आपकी आने वाली पीढ़ी आपको आप पर इसलिए जरूर फख्र करेगी कि आप उस महफिल में मौजूद थे जिसमें अब्दुल कलाम जैसे सितारे मौजूद हैं
Rightly said, Satendra. Children's Science Congress provides the children from all over the country a unique opportunity to use their scientific temperament and knowledge to make their own dreams come true. Since its inception in 1993, it has gained wide attention across the country. creating an unprecedented history. I am overwhelmed to stand in front of you in the 19th year today. Tomorrow, it will become a past part of the glorious history. Now, in KIT University, we do have a tradition to welcome and honor guests. Nurturing the same, I would like to request my friends to kindly welcome and present flowers to our respected dignitaries for today's function.
हमें ये मालूम था कि बच्चे बहुत पसंद हैं, तो एक छोटा सा बच्चा अपनी खुशी जाहिर करने के लिए सर के पास आया।
अब्दुल कलाम सर, we at the city of temples are always proud of our culture and tradition. We do have a tradition to start everything in the name of God. Nurturing the same, I would like to request our esteemed dignitaries to kindly come up for lighting.
Hamari ye reet rahi hai ki hum us sanskritik jo niyam hai unke jo taur tareeke hain unka hum anupalan karte hain. Usi ka anupalan karte hue hum apne atithi gano se ye guzarish karenge कि इसका वो हमारा जो दीप है उसको प्रज्वलित करें। हरे हे ओम द्योह शांति हे अंतरिक्ष शांति हे पृथ्वी हे शांति आपह शांति रौषधय शांति वनस्पत्यः शांति हे विश्वदेवा शांति हे ब्रह्म शांति सर्वः शांति रेव शांति सामा शांति रे शांति ओम।
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. We have already marked the onset of this program in the name of God, performed by students of KIT International School and KISS.
और जैसा कि आपको मालूम ही होगा, पूरे उड़ीसा ही नहीं, स्वागत कीजिए।
Please welcome them.
One word.
अब मैं स्वागत भाषण के लिए हमारे कुलपति प्रोफेसर कोलासर सर को आमंत्रित करता हूं।
ऑनरेबल फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम, डॉक्टर प्रसन्न कुमार पाकिस्तानी, ऑनरेबल मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट लोकसभा, General President of the 99th Indian Science Congress, Professor Geeta Wali, Mr. Saxena, Dr. B.P. Singh, Head of the NCST of the Department of Science and Technology, Professor Yashpal, all young scientists who are going to make India one of the superpower, invited delegates, teachers, those who have come from the various schools from all over the India, participants to 99th Indian Science Congress, media. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all on behalf of the Indian Science Congress Association, on behalf of the KIT and KISS group of institutions and NISER at Bhuvaneshwar. This is the 19th Children's Science Congress, which is being organized along with the Indian Science Congress, and I am truly pleased and honored that our beloved Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has agreed to be the chief guest for this function, to address all of us and to enthuse us and to see that truly India continue to march in this 21st century as a nation with scientific temper and a nation which will lead the whole world. I am also pleased and honored that Dr. Prasanna Kumar Patsani, Honorable Member of Parliament from Bhuvaneshwar, is present amongst us. He is a great poet, writer, and a parliamentarian who has been serving and getting elected years after years, and one who loves KIT group of institutions and KISS. I'm truly, sir, happy that you are here. Professor Geeta Wali is not only the general president of the 99th Indian Science Congress, but she is a spirit behind all the scientific program and all the activities which have been organized here. I know that she has worked very hard to see that this Science Congress becomes truly a memorable one. And as I mentioned yesterday, even though she had many choices, she has decided to organize or allow us to host this Congress on the campus of the KIT along with the NISER, both which are very new institutions, and that too in the state of Odisha. So, madam, I welcome you to this inaugural function of the Children's Science Congress and thank you for allowing us to host this Congress. Mr. B.P. Singh is the head of NCSTC and represent Department of Science and Technology. Department of Science and Technology supports this activity of the Children's Science Congress for last several years, and this year too it is supporting us to organize this meeting. It is because of their support and advice that we could organize this Children's Science Congress here, and I'm grateful to Dr. B.P. Singh, who is heading the NCST division, to be present here in this inaugural session. He will be talking more about this division, its functions. Sir, we welcome you to the KIT campus, and I would again request you to visit also the KIS and see the activities that we are doing. So on behalf of my founder, Dr. Achyuta Samanta, and on behalf of the KIT and KIS group of institutions, on behalf of NISER, I would like to welcome you to the Children's Science Congress. Professor Yashpal, I see him among the children sitting, a great scientist, a communicator, educationist, and we are really overwhelmed that even though he has to go for the Kalinga Award function, he is still with the children, and it is not exceptional because he loves the children, he loves the science, and he is a great communicator. Sir, thank you very much for being present here, and I welcome you on behalf of the KIT University, on behalf of the Indian Science Congress, on behalf of the NISER. It's my pleasant duty to welcome all the children, those who have come from the various schools, whose exhibits they have brought from different parts of India, their teachers, and all other children and their parents, those who are present there. Thank you very much for coming. Welcome to this great organization, and please enjoy, have a good time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind and gracious words. It is indeed an honor for us to have Professor Geeta Bali, General President of ISCA and Vice Chancellor, Karnataka State Women's University, on this occasion with us. Now I would like to request ma'am to kindly address the gathering. Ma'am, please.
Honorable and most beloved Dr. Kalamji, Honorable Member of the Parliament, Dr. Prasan Kumar Patsani, Dr. B.B. Singh, Dr. Vijayalakshmi Saxena, respected Professor Yashpalji, and Dr. T. Ramaswamy, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, all the invitees who have come here, and dear children, this will be a memorable day for you and me participating in this Children's Science Congress, having Dr. Kalamji with us. We get inspired every time we see him on the TV, every time we see his picture. We get inspired every time we think of him in our mind. This Children's Science Congress is a special program that has been incorporated in the annual Science Congress event. This is one of the major and very attractive events and very meaningful one. It's a three-day program which gives wonderful opportunity to our children to interact with all the scientists. We get as many as 7, 8, this time 11,000 delegates have registered for Science Congress, and our children get an opportunity to interact with all of them, and we are going to have 8 Nobel laureates with us. Our children, they will spend some time with our children. You can also meet them wherever they are and talk to them, and this is an opportunity for our children to appease their curiosity, clarify their doubts, and get answers for many things which is bugging their mind. To encourage young scientists, the Indian Science Congress Association has implemented a program. We have 14 sections, each dedicated for a particular branch of science, and we invite young researchers who are less than 32 years to submit their papers. These are evaluated very, very intensely by well-known scientists, and awards are given away, which carries a cash prize of 25,000, and they have the honor of receiving it from Dr. Kalamji. And Dr. Kalamji has been so kind to participate in this program. Even when he was president, even as president, he has come here. That has been a great honor for all of us, for the Science Congress, and it has inspired thousands and thousands of children over all these years. And I must briefly mention that this Children's Science Congress program has been extraordinarily well organized by the Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology. They love children, just as we have seen from their Kalinga Institute of Social Sciences. For the first time, the children's exhibition is organized in a very large scale. The children who have been selected from all over the country are here to exhibit their models, and these children are given independent stalls in the exhibition hall, and there are more than 110 stalls accommodating the award-winning projects of our children. Dr. B.P. Singh will tell more about this program, because DST has taken great pains to encourage children, and all over the country this program is organized to search for talents, to motivate every child in the country. As far as Science Congress is concerned, Science Congress also has number of programs. It also participates in this DST program, and then for young researchers, it has instituted these awards. So I wish all the children the best, and I hope they will get very rich experience participating in this program. Briefly, children are the future of nation. We must remember that India has over 3 million children living on the streets. It has over 150 million children working as bonded laborers. One out of every six girl child does not live to see her 15th birthday. Why is this happening? We are 1.2 billion. If all of us learned honestly what we are supposed to learn, if all of us did whatever research we are doing in a very honest way, and if all of us did whatever job we are doing in a very honest way, these children will not remain so. So you children, lot of hopes are in you. So I, once again, on my behalf and on behalf of Indian Science Congress Association, welcome Honorable Kalamji for this program, and thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. Now I would like to request Geeta Bali, ma'am, General President, 99th Indian Science Congress, to kindly felicitate the chief guest of today's function, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Now I would like to request Honorable former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, to release the Child Congress proceedings. Sir, please.
अब मैं हमारे अतिथि डॉक्टर बीपी सिंह, हेड एनसीएसटीसी भारत सरकार विज्ञान और तकनीकी विभाग से गुजारिश करूंगा कि वो आकर अपना परिचय दें और इस विभाग के बारे में दर्शकों को बताएं. सर प्लीज.
नमस्कार आनरेबल भारत रत्न अबुल कलाम जी प्रोफेसर गीता बाली प्रोफेसर ए एस कोलास्कर डॉक्टर पटसनी वी एल सक्सेना डिस्टिंग्विश्ड साइंटिस्ट एंड अकेडमिशियंस अमंग द ऑडियंस लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन एंड डियर चिल्ड्रन साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट व्हीकल फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एनी नेशन एंड इंडिया वॉज द कंट्री विच रिकग्नाइज्ड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस इमीजिएटली आफ्टर द इंडिपेंडेंस आवर फोर फादर्स पुट एन इंप्रेसिव अरे ऑफ नेशनल लेबोरेटरीज एंड सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स ऑन प्लेस इन द होप इंडिया विल ultimately be scientifically literate. Of late, around two decades ago, we realized that the trickle down of scientific concepts from the best of the labs in the nation to the masses ought to be strengthened and furthered. Therefore, a sub organization, a division in Department of Science and Technology was created that is called National Council for Science, Technology and Communication to sensitize, to popularize science and technology among the masses. We run a number of activities aimed at the common people so that our misbeliefs, if there is any unscientific way of looking at the issues, could be made on the basis of scientific methods and rationality. The NCSTC has two landmark activities, and one of them is National Children's Science Congress. Through this program, we aim to make our children aware and practice the scientific methods, not only in their career as a scientist, but also as a citizen of the nation. It goes without saying, we are one of the biggest functioning democracy. Many decisions which are pertaining to science and technology and development are ultimately to be taken by the people to the masses. And who can be better harbinger of taking the message to the people than the children? Honorable former President, sir, we organize Children's Science Congress right from sub-district level, taluka level. A competition based on project based on a general theme, which this year was use of soil for prosperity and conservation for posterity, to make children aware of their environment, an immediate problem which concerns to the society, and come out as far as possible, at least apply their mind, question how they can maintain the soil in a healthy condition. Right from taluka level to district level, state level and national level, this competition goes on, and we are able to enroll almost a million students plus teachers to participate in this activity. This is a program which not only make aware of scientific methods but also inculcate team spirit among the children. The another program is our Science Express, which has in 65 lakhs visitors in past 4 years. Kalam sir. Now this program has crossed the border of nation. With the help of Ministry of External Affairs, we have opened the gate for the children of Asian countries to participate in this. And for the information of audience, I would like to put on record that Honorable Abdul Kalam sir was chief guest in the concluding session of a bigger set of Children's Science Congress at Jaipur from December 27 to 31st. So much so that we received a delegate from Bangladesh also. Friends, 12th five-year plan is hardly 4 or 5 months away. 4 months away. And in the next five-year plan, we are going to concentrate on science teaching at school level. Therefore, I scheme a major program with the help of various other agencies, the major agency being MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development. We are going to put a huge program on place exclusively for science teachers at the school level in the hope that message of science, its methods, its facts will reach to the every nook and corner of the country with our objective to strengthen the scientific temper among each Indians to take scientific methods of arriving at a conclusion in decision making. The methods of science are to be applied. With these words, I wish the young children a happy, fruitful and future career in research in any branch of science. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your blessings. Now I would like to invite guest of Patshani, Honorable Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha Bhuvneshwar. Sir has been a constant source of inspiration and support for KIT University. Sir, please.
Honorable Professor A.S. Kolaskarji, the Vice Chancellor, KIT, Organizing Chairman of 99 Indian Science Congress, Honorable Madam Professor Geeta Waliji, the General President of 99 Indian Science Congress, the great writer, the great lover of children, Dr. A.P. Abdul Kalamji, Dr. B.P. Singh, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and Madam Dr. Vijayalakshmi Saxena ji, the General Secretary of 99 Indian Science Congress, the great Pradhanabal's wife, Madam my Holy Mother, Swasati Ball, and Professor Nirmalendra Rai, Professor Sasana Chudamani, and all the Professor Revar, great scholars, scientists. Let me convey my hearty gratitude on behalf of my conscience for your arrival to Bhubaneswar. Sara Bhuban ki Ishwar jahan pe hai usko Bhubaneswar kaha jata hai. Kalam ji, आपको याद है कि नहीं, आई वॉज रिप्रेजेंट यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ अच्युत सामंत टू मीट यू. आपने इतना आनंदित हुआ आगे बड़ी शू एंड ऑल्सो अवर ग्रेट चीफ मिनिस्टर नवीन पटनायक जी थी एंड अच्युत सामंत. आई टोल्ड कैटेगरिकली दैट द बैचलर दे कैन डू बेटर वर्क as Navin Patnaik did for the state, and also as Atutu Samant also doing. And the same time I told Kalamji, you are also a bachelor. You prompted me, and I am not only bachelor, I am also a brahmachari. And you are that brahmachari. Brahm means gyan. Brahm means one can attain the blissful state of consciousness. Brahm means the highest being one can attain. And you have attained that highest being of knowledge. Like Ganpati Ganesh, you have attained the highest knowledge of science. You have attained the highest science of arts. So you know the art, the art of science of being and art of living. And today, your arrival to here, that time I told, you see a man in the world who is promoting not all the kids, who is promoting our state as a whole. And Odisha is known, like Vijupatna Kalinga. And this great Atuta Samanta is promoting our state, feeding 15,000 of children. Nowhere in the world, neither no government, nor in the private universities of the globe. He is feeding 15,000, giving shelter, clothing, and also those 15,000 children are loving you like anything. The children are blooming like a flower in God's garden. They are blossoming, inviting you from Delhi to this place, Bhubaneswar, जहाँ पे आप आए हुए, ये बच्चे लोग ने आपका साथ में है, आपका you are loving the children like Pandit Nehru, and children are really, you are not only loving the children, you are also through eternal writing, propagating the holy message of knowledge which is structured in consciousness. I am not only reckoning the name of Atuta Samanta. His name is reckoned with in history of science, arts, and also globally is known for feeding the 15,000 children. Moreover, presently, man never makes the money. Presently, the money is making the man. So everybody is after money, money, money. Everybody is after the management, management. They don't know how to manage their own family. Still they are managing with money and money. Nobody is after science. Science, ye hai tamana, main nahi nara nahi de raha hu. Ye tamana desh prem ke liye nahi hai. Ye tamana ghotale ke liye hai. Ye tamana desh ko break karne ke liye hai. A woman can make a man, can break a man. The journalist friends, the media friends, you can make the country and break the country. You are knowledgeable, I salute you. But my adoration to Kalamji. Abhi time ho gaya, Kalamji. Ka means Krishna. Ka means Krishna. Ka means Konark. Ka means Kalinga. Ka means Kalam. And wo jo la hai, la means lakhya. Kya lakhya hai? Jo apna maa, घर पे उसको लक्ष्मी कहा जाता है. जो धर्म पत्नी अपना स्वामी को लक्ष्यस्थल में पहुंचने के लिए साधना करती रहती है उसको लक्ष्मी कहा जाता है. यू आर दैट लॉ, यू आर दैट मॉ. मॉ मीन्स मदरलैंड, मॉ मीन्स मनुष्य, मॉ मीन्स मनीष, मॉ मीन्स माइंड, मनो. तेणु आपण सही मन प्रण दे ओडिशा आसी करुच सलाम, हे कलाम मुच सलाम, मोर प्रणाम. এবং এই অনুষ্ঠান পৃথিবীর অযোগ্য অনুষ্ঠান হয়ে সমগ্র পৃথিবী জ্ঞান দেউ, সেইপাই সমস্ত নমস্কার করি. থিঙ্ক গ্লোবালি, ওয়ার্ক লোকালি. এ হচ্ছে অচ্যুত সামন্তর গ্রেটেস্ট ডিভাইন কন্ট্রিবিউশন, গ্রেটেস্ট আর্ট টু দ্য সোসাইটি. আই স্যালুট, আই অনার, মু প্রণাম করছি সমস্ত ওড়িয়াঙ্কু. হে শিশু মানে, তুমি হচ্ছ মো মাটি মার হীরা কান্দুল. তুমি হচ্ছ কে বা দেই পারিব তুমি মূল, তুমি এমতি পড়ো অনন্ত আকাশর ঈশ্বর আসি করিবে গেল, করিবে গেল, আগেই চলো, আগেই চলো, আগেই চলো.
থ্যাংক ইউ.
Thank you so much, sir, for your enlightening words. It is always a treat to hear from you, sir. Now I would like to request Dr. Amit Krishna Day, Executive Secretary, ISCA, to read out the names for ISCA Young Scientist Awardees. Sir, please.
Dignitaries under dais, it's a great pleasure for me to announce the name of the ISCA Young Scientist Awardees for 2011-12. As you are aware, this Young Scientist competition is held every year, where contestants from all over the country participates. We get a huge number of applications and they are screened, and ultimately a competition is held in October to finalize the candidates in each section. And this year there are 16 awardees, and the awardees gets a certificate and 25,000 rupees. Now I would like to call one by one awardees to the dais, and I request Professor Gitawari, the General President, to hand over these awards to Honorable Dr. Kalam, who would be giving it to the awardees. The first one for Agriculture and Forestry Sciences, Vigya Kesari, is not here. She has gone outside India, so she will take the award later. Now I call from Animal and Fishery and Veterinary Science section, Nitin Pathak, Department of Zoology, and Government Motilal Vigyan Mahavidyalaya Bhopal. The awardees may stand in a queue at the, near the staircase, so that we can finish it fast. The second award goes to Anthropological and Behavioral Sciences section, Sabnam, Department of Psychology of Amritsar. She is here. The next award goes to Chemical Science section, Mahesh Sundarajan from Theoretical Chemistry section, BRC, Mumbai. The next awardee is Earth System Sciences section, Poulami Ghosh, Department of Geological Sciences, Jadavpur University, Kolkata. For Engineering Science section, it is Samrat Pal of Solar and Energy Material Lab, Tejpur University, Tejpur. Environmental Sciences section, Surabhi Dipali Muduli of the Department of Environment and Sustainability, Institute of Minerals and Material Technology, Bhubaneswar. The next award goes to the Information and Communication Sciences section, Devarati Chakravarti of Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata. The award for the Material Science section goes to Ashutosh Kumar Dubey of IIT Kanpur. The next award is jointly given to two awardees for the Mathematical Sciences section. The first one is Dilip Kumar of Center of Mathematical Sciences, Kerala. And the second award goes to Suchandran Kyle of Department of Mathematics, IIT Kharagpur. He has come. The award for Medical Sciences section, including Physiology, it goes to Rajendra Singh of Central Drug Research Institute, Lucknow. Next award goes to New Biology section, which is including Biochemistry, Biophysics, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology. And it goes to Sanjeet Mukherjee of Indian Institute of Chemical Biology, Kolkata. The award for Physical Science section is jointly given to Rajesh V. Nair of Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Mumbai, and the Plant Science section goes to two awardees jointly. It is given to Rashmi Singh of Department of Botany, KN Government PG College, Bhadohi UP, and Jeremy Decker of Plant Biotechnology Laboratory, Department of Botany, Nehu, Shillong. कोई होए गया तो
एक्टर नहीं है किसी चंदन कॉल में
कोई
किसी चंदन कॉल में
कौन था किसी चंदन कॉल नहीं होगा चेतो
चंदन कॉल क्यों नहीं
वो लेफ्ट सुचंदन कॉल हैज कम थैंक यू
कि हमारे को भूल जाए भूल
दर्शकों आज जब सवेरे मैं सोच रहा था सबके बारे में कुछ लिखूं तो एक ऐसे शख्स पे आकर मेरी कलम जवाब दे गई मेरी भावनाएं शून्य हो गई और मेरी सोच एकदम फीकी पड़ गई कि मैं कहूं क्या मैं उस इंसान के बारे में क्या कहूं कहते हैं कि तारीफ तो उनकी करो ना जो काबिले तारीफ हो उनकी क्या तारीफ करो जो खुद ही एक तारीफ हो तो मैं क्या कहूं उस इंसान के बारे में सर आपके बारे में कहूं क्या कि जब आप सांसें लेते हैं तो हमारी धड़कनें चलती हैं जब आप सपने देखते हैं तो देश सोचता है आपके बारे में और यही मैं कहना चाहता हूं
When I see these young school kids, I am overwhelmed by a joyous feeling. Then I met a man who was my role model, and today I am standing in front of sir. Please welcome the missile man of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
Friends, good morning to all of you. Now, and also I like to greet all of you at the New Year greetings. Wish you all Happy New Year. Dear young friends, on the New Year, do you want to fly? Do you want to fly? On New Year, you want to fly? Have you taken breakfast today morning?
Yes,
then all of you repeat a poem. I'm going how to fly, okay? Will you repeat?
Yes,
how many of you will repeat? Can you hear me?
Yes,
I am born with potential. I am born with potential. I am born with goodness and trust. I am born with ideas and dreams. I am born with greatness. I am born with greatness. I am born with wings. I am born with wings. So, I am not meant for crawling because I have wings. I fly. Friends, how many of you want to fly? How many of you want to fly? All you gang want to fly. Then hear me carefully. I'm going to tell you how to fly. Okay. First, I would like to greet Prashna Kumar ji, MP, MBG, and then Professor Geeta Bali, General Secretary General, 99th Indian Science Congress. Friends, what is 99th Science Congress? What does it mean? 99th Science Congress, what does it mean? Next year, probably 100 science congress. 100 science congress means what does it mean? You know, friends, the earth orbiting around the sun. One orbit, how much it takes? 1 year it takes. That means science congress, Indian science congress, has orbited around the sun so far 99 times. Next year is going to complete 100 years. So my hearty congratulations for all the young scientists and who have assembled here, all the children who are assembled here on the 99th Science Congress, and you are going to see 100th Science Congress next year. Hello? Police up. You are talking. Okay. So friends, my greetings to all of you participating in the Children's Science Congress. I also greet Dr. V.P. Singh, Dr. Vijayalakshmi Saxena, my friend Professor Golaska, and Dr. Samanda, Dr. Samanda, delegates, participants, professors, teachers, and dear students and young scientists, good morning to all of you. My greetings to all of you participating in the Children's Science Congress. What a great opportunity to all of you, friends, to meet scientists of experience, youth thinkers from all parts of the country and some other friendly countries. We are the background of an environment rich with history and culture of Bhubaneswar. When I am in Odisha, Chandipur comes to my mind. That was my theatre of action for long-range missiles. So I have beautiful experiences. The great environment leads to creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge leads to technology and innovation. I would like to share a few thoughts and interact with you friends on the topic transform yourself, unique you. Carefully watch what I am saying. You have to interact with me. Transform yourself. What is the subject? Transform yourself, unique you. All of you have to transform yourself, unique you. How to do that? Unique you, that is you. All children who are assembled here, 20,000 children, unique you, that is you. When I see you friends in the first week of 2012, thousands of youth representing different parts of the country who aspire to be remembered for a unique achievement. I have a message for you. To be remembered for, you have to be unique. To be remembered for, you have to be unique you. Will you decide in the year 2012, you will become the unique you? Will you decide? You will become the unique you. Let us study together certain unique events. By unique achievers, will all of you participate in the exercise what we are going to do together? You are ready? Ready? Dear friends, just look up. You are seeing the lights, isn't it? Number of lights. When you see the light, whom do you remember? Bulbed light. Whom do you remember? Very good, Thomas Alva Edison for his invention of electronic bulb and his electrical lighting system. When you hear, just now, yesterday, Prime Minister arrived in the aircraft, when you hear the sound of airplane going over your house or Science Congress, whom do you think of? Very good children, Wright brothers proved that man could fly. Now, all of you have got telephones. Your home has got telephone. Two of my friends have got two each mobile telephone. Telephone. Whom do you think of? Very good, Alexander Graham Bell. We immediately remember Alexander Graham Bell. When everybody consider, it is a noisy place. Can you silence them? The noisy place. When everybody considered a sea travel as an experience or a voyage, a unique person questioned during his sea travel from United Kingdom to India. He was an Indian scientist. He was pondering on why the horizon where the sky and sea meet looks blue. Why the horizon where the sky and sea meet the blue? His research resulted in the phenomenon of scattering of light. Of course, he got a Nobel Prize. Who is that? very good children, Sir C.V. Raman was awarded Nobel Prize. Do you know an Indian mathematician who did not have formal higher education but inexhaustible spirit and love for mathematics, which took him to contribute to the treasure houses of mathematical research, as some of which are still under serious study and engaging all available world mathematician effort to establish formal proofs. He was a unique Indian genius who could meet the heart of the most hardened and outstanding Cambridge mathematician, Professor G.H. Hardy. Actually, G.H. Hardy discovered our mathematician when he was a young fellow. Can you think of the mathematician? Srinivasa Ramanujan, for whom every number was a divine manifestation. Do you know, friend, Chandra limit? Who discovered the Chandra limit? Chandra limit was discovered by Chandrasekhar Subramaniam. He got his Nobel Prize after his two students got his Nobel Prize. And so by using the Chandra limit, you can calculate how long the sun will shine. That means 10 billion years sun will shine as per Chandra limit equation. You can calculate how long the sun will shine. 5 billion years are over. Another 5 billion years are there. You don't need to worry. Friends, there was a great scientific lady who is known for discovering radium. Very good. She is Madame Curie. Madame Curie discovered, as you said, radium, and she was doing a research on the effect of radiation on human system. The same radiation which discovered affected her, and she sacrificed her life for removing the pain of the human life. She is the only lady who has got Madame Curie two Nobel Prize, one for physics, another for chemistry. Whenever I describe to you, young friends, just now closely hear me. Whenever I describe to you, young friends, scientific historical events, you jumped. Name of the scientist, technologist, who created the great event, they are the unique personality. They are unique personalities, isn't it? Young friends, can you join such unique performers of scientific history? Can you join? How many of you will join? You can. Definitely, let us study together how it can be made possible. How you can join the unique people. Friends, I have so far met 12 million youth in a decade's time. I learned every youth wants to be a unique. That is you. But the world around you is doing its best day and night to make you just to everybody else. Do you follow? In the home, dear young boys, young fellows and girls, you are asked by your parents to be like neighbor's children for scoring good marks. When you go to school, your teacher says, why not you become the first five rankers in the class? And yesterday Prime Minister said, we are China's overtaken, when India will become overtake China. Wherever you go, friends, they are saying you have to be somebody else or everybody else. Now, dear young friends, how many of you would like to be unique yourself? How many of you? How many of you want to be unique yourself? How many of you? Okay. The challenge, my young friends, is that you have to fight the hardest battle which any human being can ever imagine to fight, and never stop fighting until you arrive at your destined place. That is you, that is unique you. Friends, what will be your tools to fight this battle? What will be the tools to fight this battle? What are they? Have a great aim life. What is that? Great aim in life. Second one, continuously acquire the knowledge from great books, from great human beings. Continuously acquire the knowledge. Work hard. Third one is work hard. Fourth one, persevere to realize the great achievement. Any scientific work you do, some problem is there. Problem should not become your captor. You should become the captor of the problem. defeat the problem and succeed. Now, what are the unique qualities of inventors and discoverers? What are the unique qualities of inventors and discoverers? Also, I'd like to give you how you young friends can become a great inventor or discoverers. What is the unique nature of thinking minds of discoverers and inventors of the world? Dear friends, can you all repeat with me? Will you repeat with me? Yes? Inventions, discoveries have emanated from creative minds that have been constantly working and imagining the outcome in the mind. With imagining and constant effort, all the forces of the universe work for that inspired mind, thereby leading to invention and discoveries. Now, friends, there are three unique friends to make you great. They are great books, great human beings, and great teachers. You must catch hold of them. Teachers should have the capacities to nurture the creative mind and imagine the mind. Teachers should have the capacities to nurture the creative mind and imagining minds. Dear friends, can you all repeat a quote from the Bernard Shaw? Will you repeat all of you? Imagine, you are all tired, eh? Imagination is the beginning of the creation. You imagine what you desire, you will. What you imagine, at last, you create what you will. Message is, you ought to imagine. If you are an imagination, fellow of imagination, girl of imagination, you have arrived. Now, dear children, how many of you feel confidence? How many of you feel confidence? You will and will become a unique scientist, technologist, designer, great national leader with ethics. Great national leader with ethics. Now, how many of you want to become great scientists, great technologists, great designer, and great even good leader with ethics? Okay. Now I am going to tell you, in case you are in the process of taking a subject, science probably, what science can give you? Carefully hear me. What science can give you? Dear friends, since I am with these students who are shortly going to decide on what stream they should carve out for their career, that is 10 plus 1, 10 plus 2, you have to take a subject, I would like to share with you one question. What is the uniqueness of being a scientist? What is the uniqueness of being a scientist? Friends, science gives you better eyes, because science can remove the mental blindfolds and gives your brain a challenge to solve many scientific problems that are yet to be solved. When people in general talk in dimension, just less than 1 millimeter or few hundred thousand kilometer requirement flight, the scientist will easily move from behavior of proton 10 to the power of minus 15 meter to the size of visible universe approximately 10 to the power of 28 meter and 43 orders of magnitude. Most of our friends who are not in the field of science will slice the time perhaps maximum up to 100th of a second. You young fellows, you scientists, will slice the time into femtosecond, that is 10 to the power of 15 seconds, which were decide a fast photochemical reaction. When you took way back time, it was Big Bang, some 15,000 million years ago, and the beginning of the life on Earth about 3,800 million years ago. Again, you will be ahead of 17 to 18 orders of magnitude. Science indeed will connect you. Science indeed will connect you into the brains of many smart people who were there before you. Hence, science makes you feel good to stand on the shoulders of the giants like Isaac Newton, the discoverer of the laws of gravitational force, Albert Einstein, the discoverer of the general relativity theory, Stephen Hawking explained the string theory with an attempt to integrate multiple laws of nature, Sir C.V. Raman, the discoverer of the Raman effect, Chandrasekhar Subramaniam, discoverer of the Chandra limit and black hole, and Srinivasa Ramanujan, the number theory and originator. Dear friends, can you all repeat? Can you repeat now? Questioning mind is a fundamental aspect of science. You question, till you get an answer, which will bring, question will bring, the question and the answer will bring disruptive transformation in the growth of the humanity. Okay? Now I'm going to talk to you about biological system. You take our human body. Now you have to do an exercise. You take our human body. What is the human body? Science has revealed that the human body is made up of millions and millions of atoms. An average adult weighing 70 kilograms would have approximately 7 into 10 to the power of 27 atoms. That's 7 into followed by 27 zeros. For example, I am made up of myself 6 into 10 to the power of 27 atoms. This is divided by 4.7 into 10 to the power of 27 would be the hydrogen atoms. Another 1.8 into 10 to the power of 27 would be oxygen. And there are 7 into 10 to the power of 26 carbon atoms. The difference between one human being and another is determined by the sequencing of the atoms, how the atoms are arranged. Now let me give an exercise. When you go home, you are going to do this exercise. Can you determine the number of atoms in your body? Can you determine number of atoms in your body? Hint, everyone, I am giving you a hint so that you can work out. Hint, every kilogram of body weight is about 0.1 into 10 to the power of 27 atoms. Okay? I repeat with you, hint. Every 1 kg of body weight is about 0.1 into 10 to the power of 27 of atoms. When you go home, you must calculate how many atoms you are made up of. Okay? The recent human genome program reveals that human genome contains 23 pairs of chromosomes, which centers in the nucleus of every cell in the body. Each chromosome consists of a DNA double helix that is wrapped around a spool-like proteins called histones. It is estimated that the human body has 300,000 to 2 million proteins. The characterization of each protein is the most challenging task which is carried out by the Human Proteomic Project in India and abroad. The unraveling of the genomic mystery will ultimately allow the biomedical community to create a new evolutionary health future for the human race. Dear friends, can you all repeat with me? Will you repeat with me? Yes? Or you are tired? Human body is a scientific marvel of God's creation. By unraveling the mystery of the science behind it, we the humanity will improve the quality of life of the humanity. Now friends, I am going to talk to you very, very important thing, discovery of Higgs boson. Higgs boson, friends, as young scientists, you may have followed the recent development by two teams at the CERN laboratory in France toward the discovery of the God's particle. Now you will know what is God's particle. A popular name for the elementary particle called Higgs boson, named after great scientist Peter Higgs. Its existence is predicted by the standard model to explain why other elementary particles have mass. Friends, the standard model of physics is a theory concerning the electromagnetic, weak and strong nuclear interaction, which mediate the dynamics of the known subatomic particles. While this model is able to explain many physical phenomena and particles, it did not explain the fundamental question: how does an infinitely dense universe become a vast and spacious one? And how it is filled matter? In theory, as the early universe expanded, energy should have condensed into equal amounts of matter and antimatter, which would then have annihilated each other, on contrast reverting to the pure energy. On paper, the universe would be empty, but we all know it is filled with billions of stars, galaxies, stars, planets, and mostly filled with dark matter and material. This puzzle can perhaps be solved once the scientific teams, like you young fellows when you grow up, are able to establish the existence of the Higgs boson, which would be the mass-giving fundamental particle. And friends, with this area, I would like to say, I am sure some of you will enter into this area. Dear friends, can you all repeat saying, will you repeat now? History has proven that those dare to imagine the impossible are the ones who break all human limitations in every field of human endeavor. Every field of human endeavor, whether science, medicine, sports, arts, or technology, the names of the people who imagine the impossible are engraved in our history. By breaking the limits of imagination, they change the world. Question is whether you young fellows will change the world. Will you? Now I am going to talk to you about my student, okay? Your PhD student. That fellow is going to get his PhD on 8th of this month. He has done a research on brain. I am going to talk to you what that guy has done the research, okay? You want to hear? The most important results of my PhD student is, human brains has billions of neurons, as everybody knows. The quantity and quality of the neurons of the brain can be improved by providing greater and greater challenges to the brain at any age. You can be 10 years old, you can be 20 years old, you can be 100 years old. But if you give the challenge to the brain, always neurons will grow, and the quality and quantity of neurons will maintain, depends on how much challenge you are giving to the brain. A mentally challenged child is a typical case where the neurons are affected in numbers, and so the intellectual ability is drastically affected. Father George, he is my student, is made a model of the brain where the neuronal density is the key factor for the smartness of the brain. For a given density, for a given set of neuronal pairs, the number of direct connections is able to make is N1. For a given set of neurons, the number of secondary connections is N2. Similarly, N3 can be envisaged. Giving proper weightage to N1, N2, N3 we can see the smartness of the brain with a given neuronal density. It is easy to show by simulation that as the neuronal density increases for any type of random distribution, the smartness of the brain increases rapidly. Model indicates the focus damage does not diminish the capacities of the brain a lot. However, a widespread destruction of the neuron decreases the capacities drastically. If we can find, my student says, if we can find a way of increasing the neuronal density, at least in some areas, we'll be able to give better quality of life to affected children. My research student is busy in evolving a method for populating higher number of neurons through natural methods of challenging the brain, external simulation, or through the use of stem cell or combination. Dear friends, can you all repeat with me? Will you repeat with me? Thinking capacity. Thinking capacity. You have not eaten food for 3 days. Thinking capacity of the human brain is more powerful than any of the man-made system of the world. Activating the left and right hemisphere of the brain by our regular practice, challenge will ignite the supra intelligence of the human that will nurture your latent talent within you, thereby benefit the humanity as a whole. Now, message I'm giving you, young friend, you have to challenge the brain with a difficult problem. The more difficult problem brain gets it, and your brain will be very active, very powerful, very intellectual, very intelligent. Now I'm going to talk to you, science is reciprocating. Science is reciprocating. Repeat with me, science. Science is reciprocating. Dear young friend, there may be many students here specializing a particular area, but greatest research, according to me, greatest research results coming are the results of multiple disciplines coming together. For example, my student, Father John, is a computer scientist. To work on the brain, he has used multiple science and technologies like bioscience, mathematics, network theory, physics and chemistry. I am sure there may be many researchers, faculty members and students who are interested in multidisciplinary research. Let me share another experience I saw during my recent visit to laboratories of Harvard University. Harvard University, convergence of science is reciprocating. Let me give an example. Recently, I was at Harvard University a few weeks back, where I visited laboratories of many eminent professors from the Harvard School of Engineering and Applied Science. I recall how Professor Hong Kong Park showed me his invention of nano needle, which can pierce and deliver content into individual targeted biocells. That is how nanoparticle science is shaping the bioscience. Nanoparticle science shaping the bioscience. Then I met Professor Vinod Manoharan in Harvard, who showed, on the other hand, bioscience is in turn shaping nanomaterial science as well. So friends, you will find that how the multiple science are coming together. So dear friends, can you all repeat with me? Which will benefit the society. My voice is very louder than your voice. Science and technology is a non-linear tool which will benefit the society when it becomes an application for societal transformation. Thank you. So friends, finally I would like to say that Have you heard about water present moon surface? Have you heard about it? Now all of you may be aware about the finding of a molecules of water and the hydroxyl HO by the moon mineralogy mapper M3 of Chandrayaan 1 at the moon surface, which is indeed very important for the scientific community. Chandrayaan 1 is a ISRO's effort, is a fine example of international cooperation in the frontier of space science. It is all the more important because this discovery comes after 5 decades of space research effort by many nations, but India and NASA succeeded jointly in discovering the water molecule in the its maiden mission. Dear friends, what does this all mean? Teaches all of us. So next. Now finally, I would like to say that when I see you all young friends, I would like to share with you one international space program is shaping. I am sure you may contribute in solar space solar power, which you are grown up when you grow up and enter into the science and technology mission. As you all know, radiates about 10 trillion times. Sun radiates 10 trillion times the energy which human consumer across the world today. If you are able to extract even a small portion of this energy from the sun, it would sufficient to secure the energy demand of our whole world. I am advocating in many international forums on harvesting the energy from space. On 30th May 2010, I addressed the International Space Development Conference, where I talked about possibilities of harvesting energy from space through space-based solar power system. Friends, space-based solar power has many advantages over traditional terrestrial-based solar plant. First, the level of solar irradiance is about 1.4 times the extraterrestrial level than in the surface of the Earth. Second, in the case of a surface-based solar power plant, the panels can collect solar power only for 6 to 8 hours a day when sun shines. Whereas, in the case of space-based solar power, the collection time is 24 hours. Also, the space-based solar power plants are not affected by the weather condition, which may bring down the efficiency. Thus, space-based solar power plants would be far more effective in their efficiency and the power generation than the land-based system. This I am promoting throughout the world for all the space powers I have presented. And one of the big challenges is nano energy package. You want to hear about nano energy package? When you grow, you must do the rest. While one could approach the transmission of energy from space through microwaves and laser beams from space, I have proposed a thought which may be out of ordinary thoughts, but it may become a real one day. So I was thinking and attempting to transport nano energy packs like nano batteries back and forth between space and Earth. These nano energy packs may contain material hitherto unknown. Friends, I hope, I am sure all of you one day you will enter into such challenging energy task. So friends, for that it is possible you can win. Will you repeat with me? When I wish upon a star, makes no difference who I am. Anything my heart desires will come to me. So that is the power of a powerful mind and hard work. Now in conclusion, friends, I am going to talk to you culture of excellence. Friends, you all belong to a student community. We should stand for a culture of excellence. You should stand for culture of excellence. And excellence is not by accident. It's a process where an individual or continuously strives to better oneself. The performance standards are set by themselves. They work on their dreams, who focus and are prepared to take calculated risks and do not get deterred by failures as they move towards their dreams. Then they step up their dreams as they tend to reach the original targets. They strive towards their potential in the process they increase their performance, thereby multiplying further their potential, and this is an unending life cycle phenomenon. They are not in competition. They are with anyone else but themselves. That is the culture of excellence. I am sure each one of you will aspire to become a unique with culture of excellence. With these words, I inaugurate the Children's Science Congress, and I also congratulate all the award winners. My best wishes to all the participants in their mission of bringing glory to the nation through science. Now friends, I hope if you have got still nano energy in you, you ready? Okay, science is a lifetime mission. I will work and succeed. How many of you will do it? Will you do it? Okay. Wherever I am, a thought will always come to my mind. That is, what process or product I can innovate, invent and discover. Will you? I will always remember that let not my winged days be spent in vain. I realize I have to set a great scientific goal that will lead me to think high, work and persevere to realize the goal. My greatest friends will be great scientific minds, great teachers and great books. I firmly believe science will, through number of challenges and problems, no problem can defeat me. I will become captain of the problem, defeat the problem and succeed. I will work for removing the problems faced by planet Earth in the areas of water, energy, habitat, waste management and environment through the application of science and technology. My national flag flies in my heart, and whoever comes first, come in. Ah, like that. One, count. No, one minute. You don't select, I am going to select. Hello, madam, I am selecting, not you. Okay. This side. Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, only 10 fellows, okay? 10 fellows, wallet, no, you sit down there, you go, only 10 fellows, you can go ahead and sit there in your place, I will call you. Unless you go there, I will not allow them to ask questions. Go to your place, only 10, volunteers are not effective, we are not effective volunteers. No, hello, what is this? Ten fellows, send them behind fellows, no, that they are okay. Volunteers, volunteers are not effective. Ah, now. Mic, give a mic. Where is the mic, madam? Mic, give a mic. Okay, you shout, no mic. Okay.
So, I want to ask that when we talk of space-based solar power, that would require macro fabrications, big structures being made and sent into space. So, are we ready for it?
No, how to transmit the solar power? Hello? Where is it? How to transmit the solar power?
No, how are we going to construct this mega structure and send to space?
No, that, you see, what is planned is now, is a thinking stage. There is what is called hyperplane. Hyperplane will take off 100 times, 100 times landing. Every time it put a spacecraft and the geosynchronous orbit. And then the rocket will come back. Again, like that we have to build an array of solar power system. Okay?
Sir,
Next question.
Sir, I want to ask you a question. Measurement.
Pandra, put a question right there. Yes. No. Don't control it. You turn this side. Yes.
Hum produce missile, but not produce the food enough to hungry man. So, can I ask
what?
How fulfill their hungry man their...
How you will?
Hum chahte hain ki hum missile prastut karte hain, lekin hum bhookhe pyaase logon ko khana nahi de paate. तो ये क्या हमारा देश का रीति है?
Well, see, I personally believe that science is only for the people who have capacity to do that. Okay? Choice is yours. You can select science. Equally, humanity is good. Art also good, whichever you like, you do that, okay? Next. You can go ahead. Next question. Sir. No, not autograph now. Okay, next.
Sir?
Mike, where is the mic? Yes.
Good morning, sir. I'm Simadri from KIT International. Sir, I have a question. You were a professor of science, then you entered politics and became the president of India. How can we relate science and politics?
Well, politics, after all, yesterday, Prime Minister came, he's a politician. He said, science, I am going to give a lot of money. After all, money comes from politicians, okay?
Thank you, sir. Okay. Sir, you had a vision.
Okay. Next question. Yes.
Morning, sir. Yes. Sir, I'm Amit Vikram from DAV Public School here in Chandrasekharpur, Bhubaneswar. You must be knowing about the Gahirmatha Sanctuary here in Odisha. It is famous for being the breeding grounds for the olive ridler turtle. The DRDO, that is the Defense Research and Development Organization, it is located in Chandipur. It is performing its missile tests and launching the missiles into the sea. And those missiles are...
What is the question?
The missiles are affecting the marine life.
Missile?
The missiles are affecting the marine life. How can we protect them?
No, missiles, it is intended for defense, okay? Whereas the rocket system, common. Whether it's a missile or the launch vehicle, you know, rocket system common. One will put a satellite in the orbit so that it connects to human beings, okay?
No, sir.
Whereas, in the case of a missile, it delivers the payload wherever it is, okay? Okay, next.
Good morning, sir. My name is Mohammed Mazul Haq and I am from Kayaka Foundation High School, Gulbarga, Karnataka. My question...
You have to watch the time, madam. Sleeping.
My question to you is, according to the Curie effect,
Why not you, without mic you speak loud, without mic you speak.
According to the Curie effect, whenever the metal is heated up, it loses its magnetic energy if it is magnetized. The earth core is at an intensive temperature, So still, why the earth is not losing its gravitational force?
Why earth? You see, earth, you know, it rotates one axis, okay?
Yes, sir.
Then your earth will orbit around the sun. It takes, say, 1 year. But earth when the orbit, it got a gravitational force. It is balanced by, because of the movement, it balanced by the gravitational force of multiple planets, of multiple stars, you know. It is not alone.
Yes.
It is balanced by multiple systems. In space, there is a earth. Earth when it's orbit, when it's going round, it has got a centripetal force, centrifugal force. It gets balanced depending upon the speed. And also, it's not changing the orbit because of the multiple space system. They are working stars and planets, okay? Okay, next.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, I am Amrita and my question is again on Earth.
Yes?
It's about Earth. Why does the Earth rotate? I never got...
Why Earth rotates? Why Earth? If Earth does not rotate...
Yeah, even, sir, I have...
Another one minute. When the Big Bang theory happened, you know, Big Bang theory happened, many phenomena happened, okay? That means the Earth, we have got a star, okay? Star is a... you know our galaxy, what the name of our galaxy?
Milky Way.
Milky Way. Milky Way belong to one of the stars.
Yes.
Sun is our star.
Yes.
Sun has got 8 planets, okay? 8 planets. So, the Earth is one of the planets. So, all of them, everything is in orbit. The total system is in the orbit, okay?
Not revolution, rotation. From where does it get the torque?
When the Big Bang theory happened, the phenomena so high, in the force is so high, it put at space. Once you put in the space, it has to go in the orbit, okay?
Not on the orbit, on its axis, why does it rotate?
On its own axis, it rotates because that's the time of the Big Bang theory, Big Bang phenomena. Such a thing happened, okay? You send a mail to me, I'll answer to you.
We have only 2 more questions,
yes,
to go,
excuse me,
because of shortage of time.
Hello. No, you don't need to say. What you are saying?
We'll give it to
APJ at the rate of abdulkalam.com mail. All of you friends, I can answer only 3 questions because I had to go somewhere. So only 3 more questions. You don't disturb.
Hello sir, my name is Adesh, so I'm a fresh aerospace engineer graduate, sir. It's an honor to ask you this question, sir.
What is the question?
So the question is, sir, obviously moon is our next target for ISRO.
How?
Moon, because we know that helium-3 is plentifully available in moon, and it could be a useful sort of reactant for fusion reactions, nuclear fusion reactions.
How the moon would be useful, sir?
Yes, sir, how can we achieve that? What are your thoughts as to how we can proceed?
According to me, Earth, Moon, Mars, all three of them, it will become an economic entity. Okay? Since we have found there's a possibility of water in Moon, there's a tremendous potential that of economic activity another 3 decades time will take place. Earth, Moon, Mars as a single complex in power generation, in material, bringing the material, processing material, all such will happen, okay?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
I want that chairperson.
Namaste, sir.
Yeah, 1 minute, hold on.
Sir, I am a teacher in physiology.
Chairperson. 1 minute, for all of you, you note down my mail, APJ, note down, APJ@abdulkalam.com, APJ@abdulkalam.com. APJ, you send a mail to me because I can't answer all your questions. There's no time. Organization, there's no time. No, 1 minute. So you send a mail. 24 hours, you get a reply, okay? 24 hours, you'll get the reply. Okay, last question.
Namaskar, sir. I am from Kolkata. Sir, I am from Kolkata, teacher in physiology and spinal cord injured for last 6 years. I want sciences for the welfare of mankind, human beings. And everybody. So I want that children should come up with more ideas and ventures and scientific research. besides stem cell
what is the question?
Can be done, sir,
what you want?
Improving quality of life of disabled people.
Wait, improving?
Quality of life of disabled
quality
people.
Quality of life of?
Disabled people.
Disabled. My feeling is, you see, I have a friend of mine. His name is Dr. Siddharth. Dr. Siddharth. He is physically challenged. Okay? And he has done his BA, MA, PhD, and joined in a bank as a bank manager. He is a bank manager. He's a confidence. You repeat with me what I am saying? You repeat with me what I am saying?
Sir.
You repeat with me?
Yes, sir. I am repeating.
I can win.
I can win.
I can win.
I can win.
Because?
Because?
My mind.
My mind.
Is strong.
Strong.
As a diamond.
And?
As a diamond.
As a diamond.
As a diamond. I will win.
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 What you need capacity. What you need capacity. Okay? So, no. No, no, no. No. What do you say?
One more question. Last question.
They are saying no. Nanoparticle?
Abdul Kalam.
See, that's how I told you that how we are made up of millions and millions of atoms. Okay? What is atom? What is atom? Atom mainly consists of number of particles, nanoparticles. So my suggestion to you, 1 billionth size of any product is called nanoparticle. One by billion. Okay? Okay. Now all of you repeat with me. All of you repeat with me. Repeat with me. Last point. Repeat. United mind. Okay? Repeat with me. United mind. Repeat with me,
united mind
of the youth is the most powerful resource on the earth, above the earth, under the earth. All guys, you want autograph, photograph and question, you send a question to apj@abdulkalam.com, 24 hours you get the reply. Science is questioning.
Excuse me, sir.
Make your home free from corruption. Make your home free from corruption.
Hello. Excuse me.
Hello. Abdul Kalam, Vinyana Sikagamni. Abdul Kalam, Vinyana Sikagamni. Unmun Nitpada Nana, Brahmipaha Yukigade. Unmun Nitpada Nana, Brahmipaha
Yukigade. There is a one with
song. Unmanil Nan Pirandain in Badai Taviga, Yenna Pegmai, Nan Inka Nitpadaku. Unmanil Nan Pirandain in Badai Taviga, Yenna Pegmai, Nan Inka Nitpadaku. Neo, Vanathilukum Vinmin. Neo, Vanathilukum Vinmin. உன்னை தொடு மார்வத்தில் உன் அக்னி சிறுகள் கொடுத்த தன்னம்பிக்கையில் இதோ ஏறி வந்துள்ளேன் முதல் படி. இங்கு உன் முன் இளம் விஞ்ஞானியாக இந்திய விஞ்ஞானிகள் மாநாட்டில் நீ மாணவர்களின் கதாநாயகன். இரவு முழுவதும் விடுதியில் உன் பேச்சு. என்னுள் ஒரு சிறு கவலை.
I request all the volunteers to please vacate this no man's land place. I request all the volunteers to please vacate this place. Yes, all the students of CIIT, please go to your places. Now I would like to request Dr. V.L. Saxena, General Secretary of Scientific Affairs, to kindly deliver the vote of thanks. Ma'am, please.
No, please.
Good morning, everybody. Before proposing vote of thanks, I request our honorable chief guest of today's Professor Kalam, one awardee, Ms. Shabnam. She got award in anthropology and behavioral science psychology from Amritsar, Punjab. She has just now arrived and she wants award by your hands.
Yes, Sujata.
Before proposing vote of thanks, I request our honorable chief guest, Professor Kalam, that one awardee, Ms. Shabnam from Anthropology and Behavioral Science Psychology, Amritsar, Punjab. She has come now and she wants award from you. So I request Professor Kalam to give this award to Ms. Shabnam.
Thank you, ma'am.
Honorable Professor Kalam, our beloved former President of India, Honorable Professor Geeta Bali, General President, Indian Science Congress, Honorable Mr. Prasanna Kumar Prasani, Member of Parliament, just now he left, Honorable Mr. B.P. Singh, DST, Honorable Professor A.S. Kolaskar, Vice Chancellor and Organizing Chairman of 29 Science Congress, Honorable Guest, Respected Faculty Colleagues, okay, worthy and able friends, Indian Science Congress, young scientists, awardees, dear students and media personals. It is not merely a moment of pride and glory for me, but also a privilege to express my sincere gratitude to the extreme dignitaries, scientists, educationists and students efforting to convert their sapling cells into fruit-bearing tree in future. My very foremost and sincere thank and deepest heartly gratitude to Honorable Professor Kalam, for whom this line is most befitting: education is the key to excellence. Sir, your presence as a visionary scientist, as an educationist, will surely enlighten the minds of upcoming and aspiring youth of today's global world. On behalf of ISKCON, it is my proud privilege to express my gratitude to you, yourself, for sparing a few precious moments for us, and bless the science community by your informative as well as interactive abilities. Sir, I would like to add that this deserved once was blessed by receiving the ISKCON Young Scientist Award by intellectual personality by you. The award just a motivation for furthering our pursuit. The very vibrant and committed Professor Geeta Bali deserves special thanks for her innumerable devotion for the pioneering cause of scientific and technological advancement, women empowerment, and educational strength of mind. Her impeccable contribution to scientific cause would surely illuminate the interest factor in the minds of emerging scientists. Joining this stirring list of vote of thanks, I am short of words in expressing my heartiest thanks to Honorable Patsani, Member of Parliament, who just left, whose commendable contribution to infrastructure, political and educational development are a stimulus and motivation to the upcoming generation of India. Acknowledging your leadership skills, I express my deep gratitude in your absence. I am extremely grateful to Dr. B.P. Singh, DST New Delhi, for extending his full-time support and cooperation towards scientific advancement and sharpening the skill among graduating minds. A rare honor has been bestowed on me at this moment for cordially acknowledging and the enlightening work performance of Professor Ashok Kolaskar, Vice Chancellor at Kitt University, with the motivating hope that the path set by your kind self would be a torchbearer for the next fraternity. It is only but for your kind support in all fronts that has instituted the firm determination to walk miles before resting. Okay then. On behalf of the Science Congress, I willingly take the initiative of science communication activities being organized as a grassroots level to not only participate but also to constantly motivate and update the children as a major cause of contributory development. In the last, I thank all the honored guests, faculty members, students, teachers, educationists, experts, media personals, and all those who have gathered here for this promotional event. Children are the bright prospect of any nation who shoulder responsibility and carry with them the legacies handed down from our experienced torchbearers. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. Now, before we end, we request each and everybody present here to please stand and start singing the national anthem. 1, 2, 3, go.
नगनमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध हिमाचल यमुना गंगा ऊचल जलधि तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गाए तब जय
दर्शक बंधु, इस तरह से हमारा कार्यक्रम अब अपने अख्ताम को पहुंचता है। आप सभी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। शुक्रिया मंच पे जितने भी उपस्थित अतिथिगण थे
उनका
मुख्य
शाम को 7 बजे
तो सहित आम सीधा प्रसारण समाप्त करमस्कार।